I think the best way to stand out is A, talk to the most people, and B, be nice. I think that's going to stand out more than anything else. But like, you don't have to stand out. You're only competing with yourself. So you only have to stand out amongst you. There's no agent that's stopping you from talking to the most people and creating the most friendships. You understand? You're like, I want to call all the property owners in that subdivision, right? And so you're calling all the property owners in that subdivision to let them know about that listing. Most agents are so focused on the objective of that call session to be to try to sell that listing or to try to get the word out about that listing. When I'm thinking, yeah, I can get the word out about the listing, but I can also create more relationships that might want to do other deals in the future. And so people get through with the call session and they're like, man, I didn't sell that listing today. And I'm like, but you created 5 new relationships that of people that are going to do 20 deals with you over the next 20 years. You know what I mean? So there's always a backup plan. It's kind of like a buyer, right? So we all have buyers that are missing out on properties, right? There's 15 buyers for every listing, and you have buyers that wrote offers and, you know, you lost some bids. And so you're like, well, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to call that subdivision they want to live in. And so you call the subdivision. You call the subdivision, and you're like, at the end of the call session, a lot of people are like, man, gosh darn it, I didn't find my buyer or anything. You just did 100 deals over the next 20 years out of the relationships you initiated during that call session, you know? So it's like, yeah, I'm trying to find my buyer a house, but also let's create relationships in the process where it puts you in a position, bro, where you can't lose. There's always a soft spot in the market, right? AKA easy. There's an easy place in the market always. Right now it's listings. Wouldn't you agree? You get a listing, it sells in an hour, and you got 15 offers to choose from. Wouldn't you want to be on that side of the equation? But no, agents are on the buyer side of the equation competing against 15 other buyers. That's why it's tough. You're making it tough. You're going after the buyers, which it's tough for new agents because you don't have you're not established, so you pretty much don't have a choice. And most of us are working with buyers, and that's tough. And what you're telling me is that you're going to get ready to do short sales so that when the market turns, you're on top of that sector of the market. All you're doing is you're representing buyers right now in a seller's market, and then you want to go represent sellers in a buyer's market. Whereas you're going to have 15 agents fighting over the same short sale. You're going to be in the same boat. Just trying to open up your mind, guys, to really look at this from a bird's eye view. When you have a business where you're concentrating on volume of people in your market that know who you are and never forget who you are, right? Because you have this machine of a weekly email, right? You have this machine, this personal branding foundation, this mechanism, this system that's in place. And now your entire objective every single day is how many friends can I create in the market?